sexist and ableist peer relations that emphasise aggression and disrespect towards women with disabilities.
When able-bodied people are encouraged to privilege their relationships with each other over their relationships with the women with disabilities, who could be their clients or family members or just people that they know, they are going to be more inclined then to turn an eye if they see violence occurring, or they might be more inclined to excuse the violence when they themselves are the ones perpetrating it.
The kids in my class would make fun of me, and they would call me an alien. And it was painful to feel like I was the different one, and not to be included into the groups. 20 years later, I realized that it was a way for those kids to gather together, to bond with each other, by making fun of someone who has a disability. Sure, we can say they were kids, they were silly. But I'm afraid that this kind of stereotypes might have been internalized until they are adults. And we know that once you have internalized this kind of stereotype, a lifetime is not enough to get rid of them.
We all know about the bro code or the locker room talk we often hear about that every woman faces.
I've had groups of schoolboys yell the most obscene things to me while their friends over there, you know, about a few feet away, are just laughing. I think it's hilarious. I'm in public. I've just been humiliated. Do I fight back? Because if I do, I know what will happen. They'll get their phones out and they'll film me. It's like I'm there for their entertainment, because you know where it's going to go. It's going to go on social media.
The way I see it, I think that caused by peer pressure for men, or is it insecurity of being a male, or their power over other people.